بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. Welcome back dear students, how are you? Now we have alhamdulillah completed our unit, unit 4. We have completed actually our 4 units, unit 1, 2, 3, 4. We are going to start something different this time. Now I am sure it's going to be easy and we are going to just recall and go back to what we have studied in our units. So let's start. Now first of all, we have our units. You can see that we have unit 1, 2 is better than 1, and in which we talked about teamwork. We had our second unit, unit 2, influential people, in which we talked about different accomplishments and stories of success. We had unit 3, which is what will they think of next, and in which we talked about the future and all the different predictions that were made in the past for the present time, our present time actually, and also what we can expect to happen in the future. We have our unit 4, the world of TV. We completed our unit, was actually about different genres, movies, and we have here stories to write and so on. So we completed our units here. We are going to start with the expansion of the units, as you can see. Now, what is the expansion? Our objectives are to apply different grammar structures in sentences, revise vocabulary learned throughout the units, and we are going to track learning progress. So you are going to track and evaluate yourself, and if you face any kind of difficulty, you are going to go back to the unit and study and see what are the parts you need to focus on more. So we are going to start. Now in the book, we have the first task. Now in the expansion, we have A, which is to complete each sentence with other, others, and another. So we can see that we have here the graph that we studied in unit 1. Now we have the three words, other, others, and another. If you can just recall, what did we say about each part, and what are the, we have here the characteristics that we have, that we applied within the grammar lesson that we studied. Now, we have the exercise. Now, complete each sentence with other, others, and another. Note before we start that we're going to revise vocabulary as well, and you can just focus on different structures within the same sentences. Now, first of all here, I'm almost done with this cup of hot chocolate. Can you please bring me blank? Now, just think about it, that you are drinking hot chocolate and you are you need another cup. So actually here I gave you the answer is going to be from the word cup, I need another. You are going to focus on the complete sentence before you answer or before you fill in the blank. Now some predators, do you remember the word predators? We took it also in unit 1. Now we said, for example, tigers are predators. They wait for their prey to come to them. Blank predators chase their prey. Now here you are going to focus on the S in predators. Why? Because if you choose, we have your other or others. Which one can you use? So since we have your predators is plural, we are going to use the word other. Number 3, Don is so materialistic, sorry. Although he already has 2 cars, he's going to buy. So he already has 2. He is going to buy. We can agree that it is another. One lucrative crop. Now, do you remember the word lucrative? Also, it is a word that we studied in Unit 3. Now, we have here one lucrative crop is for many farmers is soybeans. Blank is corn. No, I am counting. One is soybeans, and we can add another from is. Another is corn. Moving on with the exercise we have here. He excels. Do you remember the word excels? Now we said that we have excels in unit 2, that they're influential people, they excelled in different things. So we have here, he excels in football, track, gymnastics, and a handful of blank sports. Also, you can see that we have here plural, so we can here use either other or others, but since there is the S in sports, we agree that it is going to be other. That store is a chain. Also, a chain is one of the words that we studied. So if you remember that we talked about this kind of chain or a group of businesses together. Now we have here, there are a few in Spain and Italy and blank in France and Germany. So we are talking about groups. So we have here in not just one country, more than one country. So we have here, we can choose either other or others. So since we are talking about more than one country, we agree that it's going to be others. So reading again, we have here, and others in France and Germany. Number 7, one of the most famous children's books by Dr. Seuss is The Cat in the Hat, blank, are One Fish, Two Fish, Red Fish, Blue Fish, and Horton Hatches the Egg. So actually here we are talking about two books. Since we are talking about plural, we can add here, and we have, of course, are to give us the hint, we can add other. Others are, and the names of the two books. Also note that you have to be aware that we are starting with a new sentence, so just keep in mind that you're going to write a capital here. Now the last one, one option would be to spend the money on vacation or in a vacation, blank would be to put it in a savings account. Now, if you remember this part here, it was about something in the conversation. Now, do you remember the conversation that we took in Unit 2? We talked about discussion phrases here and what would be the options that we have. So we have here one option, and another option would be to put it in a savings account. So we have here finished the first exercise. Now, coming to the second exercise, we have to rewrite the underlined sentences with used to, be used to, or would. For example, he's a very humble man. He doesn't usually take credit for anything. Now, we are going to apply using one of the words that we have here in the grammar that we took in Unit 2. He's not used to taking credit for anything. So you can see that we applied used to here in the sentence, and we changed the verb from take, the base form, into taking. Okay, so we turned it into a gerund. Also, if you remember the graph that we also designed in our lesson, and we showed the differences between the four words or the four phrases here that we have, used to, be used to, would, was, or were going to. So let's start. Now, when he lived in Riyadh, he often drove by Faisaliya Tower. Just apply one of the structures that we have here. Now, note that we have here to use used to, be used to, or would. So we can say, for example, when he lived in Riyadh, he often used to drive by Faisaliya Tower. Bobby felt lonely when his sister went to college. It felt strange not having her in the house. Now, also an important point here is to see the underlined part. Now, you do have it underlined in your book. So you are going to apply the structure within the underlined part here. So we can also here write, he was used to having her in the house. Number 3, this coffee shop is where I studied when I was in college. So I can say, I used to study at this coffee shop when I was in college. And also I can apply another sentence saying, this coffee shop is where I would study when I was in college. So I can use more than one structure here and change the sentence. It's up to you and how you feel. The sentence is more spontaneous and you can just write it in the correct form. We have the last one. He's much more materialistic now that he was then, sorry, he was when he was a teenager. Now here we can write, for example, he is much more materialistic now than he used to be when he was a teenager. Moving on with our exercise, we have here number 5. The cough was so persistent, after a while, she didn't even notice it. Now we can say that the cough was so persistent, after a while, she was used to it. When I was younger, I exercised rigorously. Do you remember the word rigorous? Now, it is one word that we took in Unit 3 when we said that something is hard or difficult, or we can also describe someone to be strict or rigorous. Now we have here, now I hardly exercise it, so I'm going to focus on the underlined part. I can change into, when I was younger, I would exercise rigorously. Or I can say, when I was younger, I used to exercise rigorously. Moving on, number 7, I usually shop in small stores. I don't usually shop in chain stores. Also, just note out that we have here the word chain. And I can change the sentence using, I'm not used to shopping in chain stores. We have number 8, he has always loved electronics. When he was a child, he and his dad built circuit boards together. Do you remember the word circuit? Also, it is a word that we studied throughout our units in Unit 3. So we have your circuit here. We can say that, for example, when he was a child, he and his dad would build circuit boards together. Or I can give another example saying, when he was a child, he and his dad used to build circuit boards together. Now, note that you can change here the structure of the sentence, as we said, depending on what verb you are going to use. Now, coming to the third exercise, we have here C in the book. Now, in the expansion, we have here answer and discuss these questions about life in the year 2015. So, what do we have here? Now we are going to just see the questions that we have. Now we're going to answer them. So basically, I'm going to just divide them here. We have here 7 questions. So let's see what we can this answer together. Of course, you may have a chance to discuss in class and to give also other answers. So do you think scientists will have found a cure for cancer? Now you are going to apply different structures that we have here. So what is the structure that we have? Of course, here you notice that it is a yes-no question. So usually when we answer, do you think scientists, we can answer, yes, they do, or yes, I do, sorry, or no, I don't. But we are going to apply different structures. So we're going to change a little bit. Instead of answering short answers, we're going to use different structures. Now, for example here, I do think scientists will have found a cure for cancer. Here in this sentence, if you notice, we studied 2 structures and they are both in the sentence. We have, first of all, I do think. So this means that I applied the emphatic do as we studied. And we have also will have found, which applies the future tense that we studied in Unit 3 as well. So we have here the future perfect tense, as you can see, the future perfect simple. Now, do you remember the table that we had here? We also showed the differences between each structure, the future perfect simple, the future perfect progressive, using going to, using will, and also we have here time expressions. Now we have question number 2. Do you think space travel will have become commonplace? So we agreed that we're going to use other structures, not just to answer in short answers. So we can answer here. I do think, emphatic, space travel will have become commonplace. Question number 3. Do you think the world will have become more peaceful? So it depends on your answer here. We can say, I do not think that the world will have become more peaceful. Here you can see that I have just applied the future simple perfect. Do you think we will have started using something other than gas to run our cars? We can answer by saying, I do think that we will have started using something other than gas to run our cars. Do you think global warming will have slowed down? So here we can apply by saying, I do think that global warming will have slowed down. You can see that I have also both structures in my sentence. Okay. Now we have six. Do you think engineers will have developed a computer capable of thoughts? Now I have my answer. I do not think that engineers will have developed a computer capable of thought. Coming to our last question here, we have number seven. Do you think scientists will have contacted life on other planets? Now I do not think that scientists will have contacted life on other planets. Now, it depends on what you are answering here. You can either add the emphasis in the sentence, or you can just apply, or even you can give other answers that are, or you can use also different structures in the sentence based on your answer. Now, we have something here different. We have D, to look at the pictures of Asma below. Write sentences about her using the following grammar points from units 1 to 4. Now, we did study lots of structures here in the four units. We are going to meet our character here. But before the character, just to revise, what are the structures that we are talking about? Now, they noted in the book that you can use used to. Was or were going to, but since we are talking about Asma here, we are going to use was going to, would, future perfect, or the future perfect progressive, and we have your future with dependent time clauses. So moving on, we have here, this is our character, which is Asma. Now, in the book, they mentioned Asma 10 years ago. And they mentioned all the different information points about her. Now we have here the marital status, single, she lives at home with parents, her occupation is a student, hobbies, she likes writing poetry, playing video games, she likes sleeping late, spending time with friends. We have here dreams to become a professor, to get married and have kids, to have laser eye surgery. Now this is one thing. If we want to just apply our sentences here, we can say, for example, 10 years ago, Asma used to eat unhealthy food. She was going to be a history professor. She would eat while she was studying. Now here you can change. There are lots of information about Asma here. You can use any type of information that you like about her that is mentioned in the book and apply the structure that you feel suitable for it. On the other hand, we have the other part, which is Asma 10 years from now. So it's like a prediction. What is Asma going to be when after 10 years? So she would be married with two children, her occupation history professor, writing poetry, gardening. We have here she likes spending time with family, eating healthy foods, and she dreams to get more sleep, so since she has children. So here we can change and say that we have here, in 10 years, Asma will have gotten married. She will have had two children. Asma will have become a professor or a history professor here. In 10 years, Asma will have been eating healthier foods for a long time. So we have here, we use different structures as you can see, and as I mentioned before, you can change and write whatever you wish. Now, the last exercise that we have here in our part of the expansion is to complete each sentence by adding either both and, not only, but also, either or, neither nor. Now, if you remember that these are all paired conjunctions, we did study the difference between paired conjunctions and we have coordinating conjunctions. So we have our exercise. Complete each sentence by adding both and, not only, but also either or, neither nor. And note that some items, more than one answer may be possible. So let's read. We have number one, blank. We have here Beijing, blank, Shanghai are cities in China. Now note that we have here two parts, so that's why we have two blanks here. So what do you feel that is suitable? We can say, for example, that both Beijing and Shanghai, are cities in China. All numbers blank, even, blank, odd. So we can say here, what do you think we have here? All numbers either are either even or odd. Now here, if you apply one part, the second part would be easy to apply with it. So you have to just focus on what is the meaning exactly in the sentence. Completing here, we have here solar energy is clean, renewable. So we can say that we have here both solar energy is both clean and renewable. Or you can use another structure here and say that solar energy is not only clean, but also renewable. Moving on, we have here number four. Now we have here, we have Ayrton Senna, Jim Clark were famous race car drivers. So we are talking about two race car drivers here. We can say that both Senna and Clark are famous or were famous race car drivers. In the Spanish language, nouns are masculine, feminine. So here, note that we have the two words masculine and feminine. We are going to study the meanings of them, if you do not know them, inshallah, in our next semester. We have here either masculine or feminine. We have number six, Finding Nemo, The Lion King are animated films. So both, as we can say, Finding Nemo and The Lion King are animated films. Coming to our last four that we have here, studies have found that blank men, women talk more than the other. So here, there are studies that show that men talk more than women or the opposite. So we can say that neither men nor women talk more than the other. Blank cars, blank airplanes existed 200 years ago. So we are talking about 200 years ago. Did they exist, cars and airplanes? So here we can agree that neither cars nor airplanes. And also I remind you to pay attention and watch out for your capital letters. The word change can mean coins to become different. So we have here the word change can mean blank coins, blank to become different. What do you feel is suitable here? We can add, we have here either count coins or to become different. Some words in the English language like conflict and suspect are blank verbs, and verbs. So actually here I have both verbs and nouns, or I can change and say not only nouns, but also verbs. So you can see that we have two sentences that we applied two structures in them. So our outline for the day, we have started the expansion part in our semester. We have revised grammatical forms that we have studied throughout the units. We applied grammatical structures and we completed exercises and tasks in the expansion. We are going to have more exercises in our expansion parts, so you can just go on with them, study them, and be ready for the next lesson, inshallah.